bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
Here's Rashad Penny, first carry for the former San Diego State Aztec. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. On second down, Wilson. Going right side here, and that's complete. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And all the way in, touchdown, Seattle. A big play there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown.
The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. As the season winds down and you look at them in totality, you know, the offense has struggled. The defense has been pretty good, so I would imagine the changes this offseason may be more on the offensive side of the ball.
And this is where we always hear the term complementary football, because as you noted, the defense has played well enough for them to win games, and the offense has held them back. So they've got to reward that defense by improving on offense. I don't know if you make a change of quarterback, running back, tight end. It doesn't matter. Get better players, better system, so they can play to the standards of the defense, and the win column will result.
And they'll go on the ground. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Here we go. 180!
Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
On play action, now Garoppolo. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But an alert 49er able to gain possession, so they will indeed hold on to the pigskin. I'll call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Miles Jack with a big-time sack on third down, and it'll be a loss of 7. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And this will be taken at the 13. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that officially. Give him 15, and it'll be Seahawk football, 1st and 10. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things in.
And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down. Give him 30 yards there. You know, he's already thrown for more yardage in this first quarter than he did all of last week.
And I could be snarky here and say, well, he didn't throw for a lot of yards last week. But the bottom line is he put in a great week of practice and really came out ready to go in this one.
Penny, a first down carry. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about three down to the 38.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
Back to the ground. This time it's Martin. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
And that's the big fella's M.O. right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
On second down, here's Penny. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. Tackle that time by Jarquiski Tart. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
They'll run it. Here's Martin. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. But just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield. Guy can take it the distance. But in short yardage, trying to pick up first downs, that big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Here's a give to Penny, and he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. On second down, Martin, and not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
An extra DB for the 49ers now on third. Wilson. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks for those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
Maybe a little fortunate there. That was leaking a little, maybe leaking a lot, but he got it.
Yeah, he actually was able to make it work. How about the body language, though, right? As he's watching that ball leak to the right, trying to bring it back in, and had just enough to get it done.
The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
Punt's better.
Drive.
Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn into first downs and hopefully points.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. Here's a second and two now from the 33.
Garoppolo throwing on second. That's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Garoppolo now, first down throw. Going deep for Diggs. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
The name of the game, as always on defense, put pressure on the quarterback. And that's exactly what they've done today. It looks like they've got him a little bit rattled. That would have been the second interception in the first half.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did. And they insert their dime package, six DBs here on third and six.
Expecting pass all the way. From midfield, here's Garoppolo. And he's able to find Diggs. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. First grab so far for Diggs. It's a first down.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered. But how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. And his throw here is incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. Back to the air on second. It's Garoppolo. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. He was trying to get that one to Allen that time, and it's third down. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Garoppolo again. Open man, it's Allen. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. And they've got another first and 10 as the penalty keeps this drive moving. Now they'll run it on the toss. Fights free at the five. And he's brought down. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
Well, they've been practicing goal line offense all week. Let's see if they're able to capitalize here. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. A great effort there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the 49ers are back within a score. And his kick is right through.
Gano out to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best.
Put your foot on the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try and increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. And off comes DeMartin. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Penny. And very little running room there. He did get a couple up to the 49.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now a run with Martin. And he's got this one across midfield into 49er territory. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first. Here's Wilson. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
All right, need you to check my eyes here. This entire unit defensively, I think, has looked really strong in the first half, especially in the secondary. They've been cohesive, fast to the football. We just saw another example arriving there to help knock that one away.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. They run with Breida. He takes this for three to the 29.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
The Niners on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 7. Garoppolo to throw. Offside caught by Diggs. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Not something you want to see in week 16 or any week, really. We'll be right back. Too shy of the 40. Yeah, Here's Breida. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Yeah, that was a safety that came through and made the play. But there's no doubt in my mind, he hits like a linebacker. And we see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss.
On second down, here's Garoppolo. Going up top. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end pass rush. They've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
The Niners on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and 11.
Here we go, here we go. Black 80!
A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. Garoppolo, 4 out of 10 throwing the ball in this first half, but he's got a first down here. To throw is Garoppolo. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
Here we go, here we go.
Garoppolo again here on 2nd and 10. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they had incompletions on 1st and 2nd down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now, since it's 4th down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to 3. And Gano's kick is right through. And that will knot things up here late in the first half. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the third book trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you 6?
The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And 2 interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw 2 interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny United?
No, not quite of that level and not of that age. But I remember...
I was going for the age. He's got a man! Complete! And all the way in! Touchdown, Seattle! A big play there! His 4th touchdown on the year! And the Seahawks get the quick strike touchdown. Lux with the extra point, and that makes it a 17-10 score. Lux now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The 49ers offense making its way back out there. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Final 24 seconds of the first half as they come up here first and 10. Throwing now is Garoppolo. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. Well, they've already allowed 3 sacks in this first half. Now a holding penalty.
So I think drastic measures had to be taken, right? The regular way was not working. He was getting hit almost every snap, it felt like. They had to try and keep him upright.
Working from the gun, Garoppolo. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. Yeah, he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Garoppolo to throw on second down. Open man is Amari Darbo, complete. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number 2. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Garoppolo, a final shot here before half. All going deep here for Taylor. And that is incomplete. So we've reached halftime here. Let's throw in a broadcaster cliche, shall we? Both teams looking for a gift on Christmas Eve. As we send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman. The Seahawks with the advantage, and they get the football first as the second half is underway. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Breida. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Give him 2 on that run, and they're still left looking at a 3rd and about 9 to go.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first 2 plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a 3rd and long at the outset of this drive. The Niners on 3rd down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 9. To throw. It's Garoppolo. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Seahawks have recovered. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
They try to fire up the running game with Martin. Oh, look at the juke. And stacked a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down. Now a
that's Wilson. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off down at the two. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in December.
Season of giving.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
And he'll get him a little bit of breathing room across the 5 to the 6 yard line. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. A little more room here on 2nd and 6 from the 6. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
The Niners on 3rd down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This will be 3rd and 5. Is going to be incomplete.
And we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Let's take it at around the 40. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And the Seahawks will have great field position to start this drive. They take over on the short side of the field. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Flush to his right. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. Throwing right, and that's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That'll put him at 95 receiving yards now as he's got a first down. First down, here's the run with Martin. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
They run it again with Martin. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. It'll be a loss of 1, and that's going to bring up a 3rd down. Now Martin. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. So they've been in the red zone 3 times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on 2nd and goal? They come out here in the eye. They'll try and run for it with Penny. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here this close. Sneak it?
I don't think you even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
From the 2 now, 2nd and goal. He's going to get it running right. And he will not be denied.
zone. Touchdown, Seahawks. Rashad Penny, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. And it's up and good. Lutz now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawk defense. J.J. Watt in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year. Here comes the 49ers punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. On the NFL scoreboard elsewhere, third quarter down in Arizona. It's the Cardinals. They are up in that game to this point. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at about the 32. They start the drive with Martin. And some room to maneuver. He's got the lane, and there he goes. That's a big-time run there by Martin. 59 yards. One of the reasons that this team is on this win streak, big runs like that.
When you see runs like that broken off, you know this is a team that's confident running the football. A big reason why this streak has occurred, they've come together, had a plan, and stuck to it. And when you get big-time runs like that, makes it easier to stay with it, doesn't it?
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Get your backs to the goal line. I can hear my high school coach right now. This is when force meets force. Got to be physical in order to win this battle.
Yeah, that's where the physicality pays off. A nice job forcing the contact and forcing the incompletion.
Yeah, Coach Ford would have loved that play.
That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
A big play to start the drive got him in this position, but this defense has held firm since, and now it's third and goal. To throw is Wilson. It's a loss of 10 yards on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first, this one from 38. And Lutz puts this one through. And that will extend their lead even further. So a good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coach is always talking about finishing a drive with a kick. Two of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Back now in Seattle, Washington. It's 49er football, but some ground to cover. They find themselves behind as we hit the fourth and final quarter. They run a draw here on second down, and he'll get this up only to about the 33. A three-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. Fullback try and push the pile. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Watching that run takes me back to something a famous old coach once said. Any player he wants on his team, he wants him to be agile, mobile, and most definitely hostile.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's up across midfield and down into Seattle territory. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. At 5 yards on the play there, as the drive will continue. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10.
Here we go.
They go play action here on first down. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. A really good pickup of 28 yards. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. And it's complete in the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. George Kittle, his third touchdown now on the year. And the 49ers get a score closer. Gano the extra point, and that will shave one more off this lead. Gano out to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
We got three.
Now it's the backup, Cousins. And he finds a man on a crossing route. And they'll get him down here at the 23. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
The Seahawks on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and 5. Cousins now. He'll rifle this one deep. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. And on the ground they go with the running back. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The tackle by Eric Armstead.
He may be a bit undersized compared to the modern-day NFL defensive tackle, but what he lacks in size, he definitely makes up for in his ability to make tackles in the run game as well.
And they'll go on the ground. And down to the 36-yard line here. That second down run, a big help. The 7 yards leaves them with just a 3rd and 3 now.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And a short gain down to about the 33. The ball still a few inches shy of the marker after the 3-yard run. So now a little soul searching on fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, it's an even 50-yard attempt. And Lutz's kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So they settle for just the 3, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the 4th.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but they still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
And a nice return sets them up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And he'll work this one up to about the 38. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 2.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through 3 quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks. And they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags. And I believe this is going to be a first down. And now it's 1st and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Garoppolo now, 1st down throw.
And he's got the open man. It's Allen on the comebacker. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. Got a guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. So after the sack here, second and 14. Garoppolo. This is caught. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. As his guys are in for six, and the 49ers have cut it back within a score. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And oh, it's blocked. It's picked up, a live ball here, remember. And they were hoping to get down there, get the score, and get this thing into overtime. How deflating.
Absolutely. I mean, let's face it, heartbreaking. They had an opportunity, had a chance, and probably were feeling pretty good about what was going on, and that was taken away from them by their own mistake.
Yeah, the opportunity squashed. And the Seahawks, looks like they've recovered. They have. A tough one there. They certainly wanted that one. They needed it, but they didn't absolutely have to get it. They still do have three timeouts.
You're exactly right. They had to attempt it, but even though they didn't get it, as you noted, with three timeouts, if they can get these stops on defense, all hope is not lost.
And they'll run it here. And he's going to be met at about the 43. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. Just a couple on the ground there, and that's going to bring up third and about six. And the 49ers going to take another timeout as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Trying the ground game here with the running back. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. No good, and this score will stay right where it is. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. The 49ers moving hastily. They're scurrying to the line. They'll look to throw. And, oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. A very solid gain of 27.
And this is obviously a spot where you lean on your stars. Get the ball to them in open space and let them do what they do.
Garoppolo now, perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's 1st and 10.
Here we go.
He'll look to throw. This will be caught inside the 10. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. Back to throw, and it's caught. It's a touchdown. So they rally here in the final minute, and they're an extra point away from tying this game. So getting the big touchdown they needed late in the fourth, now what do? You conservative and just tie it up?
No, I think you put your practice into game situation. Go as fast as possible. You already have your play call ready to go. Go for two and decide it right now.
All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. He's back to throw. And he is in for the two. I still can't believe they went for it, but they've got themselves a lead here late in the ball game. Gano out to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down. The 23-yard line, and out now come the Seahawks. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. And a big turnover there as his guy. We'll get the football back.
Another tote for the workhorse, Martin.
And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
We can't be totally sure that that was by design, but we do know that a lot of kickers like the ball in the right hash in order to kick the field goal.
Again, it's Martin.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6. On third down, that's Martin. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Now the timeout will be called, so they're in field goal range with 3 seconds left. And off the upright, and it caroms in. It's good. The kick is good, and that writes a crazy finish to this one. But Charles, we saw a comeback bid fall just a little short, but give them credit. They were able to hold on, withstand that comeback, and ultimately win it by the slim margin.
And bottom line, when it's all said and done, they don't ask you how much you won by. They just want to know, did you win? And that they did.
So for the Seahawks, it's another win for them, and you wonder if they want a redo on that one loss as they sit now at 14-1. And they will hit the road next week to take on the New York Giants. Meanwhile, for the Niners, things get even uglier now as they fall to 2-13. And they'll be back home next week as they're set to take on the Cincinnati Bengals. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
Superstar, superstar, superstar.